The gas sector in Victoria is going to need to look very different in 2050 if we're going to reduce the worst effects of climate change and meet our emission reduction targets. With more than 2 million households and businesses and commercial customers of natural gas in Victoria, the scale of getting to net zero in our gas system is one of really very great complexity. But it is achievable if we begin now. Taking action this decade is really important if we're going to achieve the economic opportunities and the jobs growth that can come from a clean energy economy.
Victoria's extensive gas infrastructure is privately owned, but the Victorian Government can play a lead role in the transition to net zero. As part of our advice to the Victorian Government on the future of the state's gas infrastructure, we've made 11 recommendations to help navigate the transformation of the gas sector. With the right planning and ongoing commitment, Victoria can reach its emission reduction targets. We can have sensible use of our existing gas infrastructure and minimise cost to consumers.
We're recommending immediate and sustained investment in energy efficiency for households, particularly for people who are on low incomes. There are also big opportunities for small businesses and industrial users to increase their energy efficiency and reduce their reliance on natural gas. By improving efficiency, we can reduce emissions and retain natural gas supplies for manufacturing industries that don't have an alternative.
By choosing to improve energy efficiency, we can save money and improve the comfort and safety of our homes, especially in extreme weather. Saving energy also reduces the amount of new energy infrastructure we need to build, further saving money for consumers.
The decade ahead is a great opportunity for the Victorian Government to co-invest with industry on scaling up biogas production and to fast-track development of Victoria's hydrogen industry.
The Victorian Government can significantly reduce its own gas use, particularly in our hospitals and schools, and align its policies with its net zero targets. The 2030s will be a critical decade for repurposing or decommissioning some parts of the gas network, depending on the uptake of renewable gases like hydrogen and biogas. This will be the decade when large-scale appliance switching for households, businesses, and industry may be needed, continuing through the 2040s.
With strong leadership and collaboration between government and the private sector, Victorians can benefit from new jobs, cheaper energy, and a safer climate. For more information, visit infrastructurevictoria.com.au.